Hello. I started a new cover project for a theme which I wanted to cover for a long time. It's the score, theme score for the last portion of the movie The Good, the Bad and the Ugly, the trio, Il Triello. It's basically a gun duel with three people. So I think there's only one movie out there where there's a gun duel, a gun trio. It's the moment of the movie. And it's quite an old movie. I think it came out 1967. But yeah, I grew up with it and I always loved it. And I especially love the music. And Ennio Morricone, of course, he's one of my all-time favorite. I was kind of researching the chords and the melody, and I was shocked that on pretty much every page, not all of them, but pretty much every page, the chords are wrong. The chords say A minor. A minor. There is nowhere in this song is A minor. And the tune is not in A minor, it's in D minor. Big difference. But yeah, it says A minor. I don't understand. I don't know. So that's why I will just want to go through quickly. And you might know what I'm talking about. So this is this. So you might recognize that. A minor, by the way, the tune before, The Ecstasy of Gold, is in A minor. That's in A minor, but the trio is in D minor. I will not play it perfectly because I'm still learning it, but I thought it would be nice to share what the chords are really are and what the melody is. On the score, in the movie, you can't really know exactly how it plays it and how the guitar is tuned, because I'm not yet sure if the guitar is either tuned regularly or if the lower string is tuned down to D. Because there's a section, the middle part, where it sounds like a guitar plays with a lower string, with a D, with the lower string tuned to D. But then it becomes also more difficult to play, so that's why I assume it's tuned correctly. It's tuned with the standard tuning in A and E. There are a lot of different ways on how you can play it, but that's how I'm gonna play it now, which is the most comfortable for me. You have this like intro where it's like the strings are slowly coming in, and you have in the background, you have like this melody, like a very soft melody, and it comes in and then builds up and it's drops with a bell kind of sound, and then the guitar starts with this. And there's other ways you can play it. You can play it like this. This is D, E, so these are the three notes on that string, on the D string, and then the A. That's probably because a lot of people think it's A minor, but it's not. It's D minor. I'm using a hammer-on kind of move here. So I move from the E to the F and then I pick the D. I don't know exactly how often, I haven't counted it yet. But yeah, you can listen to it on Spotify or YouTube or any other streaming software app, or you play it here, it's also possible. It's almost a bit more comfortable. So you basically play the E and the F on the A string. And then it comes second time. I think in reality it just still plays the D at the end, but I just want to indicate that it's actually a G in the bass. So at the beginning you have I just played the chords just so that you can hear the harmonic kind of context. And then in the background you have this like soft melody continuing. And then it goes to, so here I play the G, A, I'm using again a hammer on technique, G to A, and then F, and then C. F major. And then D again. So the whole thing all together. And then just moving basically the same kind of shape down and play the C major. It goes up here. Play the A on the 12th fret and the open strings, the B, G and D. I don't like that actually that much. I like to play it like this. Because these open strings sound a bit sounds too open stringy. And then it goes up, and that's also a reason why I like to use it, because it's just shifting the position. here. We go down onto the A, E, and strum the A major. And then the trumpet starts. So this is D minor, just the D minor you learned in school, and then A sus. So it's an A, just an A with when you move your ring finger up one fret, you're gonna get this suspended sound. Then again back to D minor. C. And here it becomes interesting. And on no page online I saw the chord. So this is D minor. Then we have E major 7. But it's basically just using these strings here. So we're here on a D minor, and then we just move the two fingers up. It's basically a dominant 7 leading back to the A. The E dominant 7 leads back to A. So we go from D minor, E7, D7, and then F, G, and F. Then to C. Thank you. Yeah, and I'm just give you a quick impression of how this cover version will sound like.